Shalom family, shalom gods. I'm coming to you guys today with another video, and we're gonna just talk about, no, I wasn't gonna talk about this. But somebody just left a comment, Queen of the South, hey sis. So I'm just like, man, we gotta break this down. Let's just do it for our lay down. Okay, so we're going to talk about this because what's going on is this video is depicting that Adam was beguiled in the garden, okay? Which is something that I've already explained to you guys, that it wasn't Eve who was beguiled, that it was Adam. But people don't read the scriptures for themselves. You know, they are kind of like taught what to believe and kept away from the truth. So they watching this video and they don't understand what's going on, and we're about to break it all down. Okay, so we're going to watch a little bit of the video because I don't want to get copyright. So we're going to just watch a little bit. Let's just see what we got here.
In life, we hide the parts of ourselves we don't want the world to see. We lock them away. We tell them no. We banish them.
Okay, now I'm going to be stopping it. Now notice, you're going to notice that the snake, the serpent, go through the water, right?
But here, we don't.
Now I'm going to just be stopping it and talking and stuff, because like I said, I don't want to get copyright, so I'm just trying to.
Welcome to Montero.
But y'all see him going through the water. That's important. That's something we're going to talk about.
I caught it bad just today.
Okay. Now, before we move on, I just want to get one scripture really quick, and it's Ezekiel 29, because I just want to show y'all why that serpent was going through the water. So it says, speak and say, thus saith the Lord God, behold, I am against thee, Pharaoh, king of Egypt, the great dragon that lieth in the midst of his rivers, which have said, my river is my own and I've made it for myself. So that's why they showed you the snake going through the waters. It's symbolism. It's real quick. And if you don't know what they're showing you, you ain't going to catch on. So then they go to show the serpent coming down from the tree, right? And we're going to talk about who the serpent is. But this is Adam, and I'm going to prove it to y'all. We're going to read it. Watch.
Hey, you hear me with a call to your place. Ain't been out in a while anyway. Was hoping I could catch you throwing smiles in my face.
Romantic talking, you don't even have to try. You're cute enough to fuck with me.
This video is so weird. Like, every time I watch it, I just get, like, crazy.
Night, looking at the table, all I see is bleeding white. Baby, you living the life, but nigga, you ain't living right. Cocaine.
Now, y'all got to pay attention to the words, because he's talking about living in the dark, sin, etc., etc., right? And if you guys know, we talked about earlier about that when Jesus said, if thy eye be evil, and we know that word evil in Hebrew is ra. So if thy eye be ra, then thy whole body shall be full of darkness. So let's take a look at what is actually being stated here.
Get with your friends. You live in the dark, boy. I cannot pretend.
You live in the dark. I cannot pretend. Now the serpent is hypnotizing him. We got to pay attention to all of this because we about to read. I'm about to show y'all everything that's happening in this video.
Face, don't leave you to sin. If you've been in your garden, you know that you can.
Call me when you want. Call me when you need. Call me.
If even in your garden, you know that you can. Okay, so I'm trying to tell y'all, Eve, it was Adam who was beguiled, right? And he blamed it on Eve. He framed her. That's also in the Bible.
In the morning, I'll be on the way. Call me when you want. Call me when you need. Call me out by your name. I'll be on the way like you.
Okay, that's enough. We're going to stop it right there. So, the song is called Montero. And if you break the words down, M-O-N-T is Mount and Row. So, it's Mount Row. And then vowels are interchangeable. So, O and A is interchangeable, which becomes Mount Ra. And this is actually the mountain in the west where they said, Ra fought Apophis or Apap. And we know this is who we're dealing with because when we go down, when we read, it says, let's see. Where is it? Talk about how, if anybody know about this myth, about how Apap hypnotized Ra. He would hypnotize Ra. Let's see. So let's just read it. We'll come across it. We'll come across it. So Apap, also spelled Apepi or Apophis, was the ancient Egyptian deity who embodied chaos and was thus the opponent of light and Maat, order, truth. He appears in art as a giant serpent. His name is reconstructed by Egyptologists as Apapi, a father, Apapi, a father, okay? And Atum Ra is the same story as Adam from the Bible, from what I'm gathering. From what, you know, I've been telling you guys that we was going to talk about the evil eye and all of that. We never got around to it. So this kind of got to do with it. So Apophis, right? And we know that it got to do with that because when you look up, I was looking at some of the hieroglyphs. When you look at the word for father, it's a snake in the word for father. And when you look at the word for mother, it's either an eagle or a vulture. I couldn't really make it out. It looked like a vulture, though, but either one, an eagle or a vulture. Eagles and vultures is used interchangeably in the Bible as well. We don't know if they just did that on accident or if it's really something to it. Okay, so it's he appears in art as a giant serpent, his name reconstructed by Egyptologists as Apapi. As it is written and survived in later Coptic as Apaph or Apap. Apap was first mentioned in the 8th dynasty, and he was honored in the names of the 14th dynasty king Apepi and of the great Hyksos king Apophis. So let's say Ra was a solar deity, bringer of light, which is disputable, and thus the upholder of Maat. Apep was viewed as the greatest enemy of Ra, and thus was given the title Enemy of Ra and also Lord of Chaos. Apep was seen as a giant snake or serpent, leading to such titles as Serpent from the Nile and Evil Dragon. So we just read that in Ezekiel 29, the great serpent in the Mississippi rivers, right, the Nile. Some elaborations said that he stretched 16 yards in length and had a head made of flint already on Nakada. So it's a snake was painted on the inside rim, combined with other desert and aquatic animals as a possible enemy of a deity, possibly a solar deity, who was invisibly hunting a big rowing vessel. So it says, one thing I want to talk about it, because it say, while in most texts, Apap is described as a giant snake, he is sometimes depicted as a crocodile. It says the few descriptions of Apep. The few descriptions of Apep's origin and myth I was just getting down low usually demonstrates that it was born after Ra, usually from his umbilical cord. Now this is important because we talked about not cutting the umbilical cord too soon, right? Your connection to mother. That's basically what it's talking about. His connection to mother, his connection to my was cut off, okay? So it's combined with its absence from Egyptian creation myths, this has been interpreted as suggesting that Apap was not a primordial force in Egyptian theology, but a sequence of Ra's birth. This suggests that evil in Egyptian theology is the consequence of an individual's own struggles against non-existence. Now, when we talk about the scripture, Adam was called the wicked one. Okay, when the scriptures say Cain was of that wicked one. It's talking about Adam. Okay, because we're going to talk about why Adam was wicked. And it's, we just showed it in the video, because he slept with the serpent. And when you look up that word touch, when God said don't touch it, it means lie with a woman. And for a long time, y'all, I was saying, you know, Adam lay with another woman. I don't know about that, because the scripture said, do not lie with mankind as thou lie with womankind. So did Adam lay with a man? And it say that Adam hid the iniquity in his heart, because I think Adam liked it. Y'all understand what's going on? Look, so let's find the part where it say that Apep, a few descriptions of Apep's origin and myth usually demonstrate that it was born after Ra. Da, 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 da. Okay, where is the part where it say, I'll say, tales of Apep's battle against Ra were elaborated during the New Kingdom. Storytellers said that every day Apep must lie below the horizon and not persist in the mortal kingdom. This appropriately made him a part of the underworld. In some stories, Apep waited for Ra in a western mountain called Baku, where the sun set. And in others, Apep lurked just before dawn. Now, when the sun sets, it's like falling asleep. You go to sleep when the sun set, right? And Ra became Atum, right? Ra became Atum. And we know Atum is Adam, right? So this is what it's telling you. So it's a, this... So it say, this appropriately made him a part of the underworld. In some stories, Apep waited for Ra in a western mountain called Baku. Okay, we read that. The wide range of Apep's possible locations gained him the title World Encircler. It was thought that his terrifying roar would cause the underworld to rumble. Myths sometimes say that Apep was trapped there because he had been the previous chief god overthrown by Ra, or because he was evil and had been in prison. So I don't know. Where the heck is this at? Okay, come on now. What? Okay. It's on here somewhere. I don't know why, I just can't see it. I told y'all I'm going blind. Okay, so let's just keep reading, because it'll pop up. It's on here. So it's a, the coffin text implied that Apep used, it's right there, the next line. If I would have just kept reading, sorry y'all. The coffin text implied that Apep used a magical gaze to overwhelm Ra and his entourage. Ra was assisted by a number of defenders who traveled with him, including Set and possibly the Eye of Ra, which we know as the Divine Feminine. And it tell you that Apep was actually, and look, we get this serpent in the tree of knowledge of good and evil. And we got this lion. They say that the serpent was defeated by a cat who they said was Ra. No, that's not Ra. That's the lioness. That's the Divine Feminine. Okay, that's Maya, where it tell you the Eye of Ra is depicted as a lioness, etc. Which is the scripture. And you can see that the paw of the cat is on this, or the lion is on the serpent's head. And when you read the Catholic Bible, it tell the truth. It say that the woman will bruise the serpent's head. The woman will, not the man. The woman will, which we have been talking about, y'all. So we can see that it's the same story. Adam was the wicked one, okay? He was after the likeness of Satan. And this was the download that just came to me, because at the end of that video, you can see that he was doing a lap dance for Satan. Then he killed Satan, and he became Satan, right? Well, the scripture say that Adam was the wicked one, right? And it say that this scripture just came to my head when I had that pause. What do it say? Do it say after the likeness of Satan that wicked will be revealed? That wicked be revealed. And then shall that wicked be revealed, whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of her mouth, and shall destroy with the brightness of her coming, because it's a her. They just changing stuff. So listen, Adam was the wicked one. Say Adam. And Eve, see, remember, if you guys understand, I just talked to you guys about this. For the first Adam, bearing a wicked heart, transgressed and was overcome, and so be all they that are born of him. Cain was of that wicked one. Talking about Adam, okay, not Satan. And this lawless one cometh after the working of Satan, okay. And then shall that wicked be revealed, whom the Lord shall consume. It say whose working is after Satan. Hold on. Even him whose coming is after the working of Satan with all power and signs and lying wonders. So they showed y'all Adam becoming Satan at the end, the wicked one. Okay. So this is what that video is depicting in Mount Ra. Adam, when the sun set, when he fell asleep, he became Adam, right? And the serpent came and did his gaze thing, beguiled him. Because, see, what people don't realize is the scriptures say the first shall be the last, right? So it say Adam was first. For Adam was first, then Eve. And Adam was not deceived, but the woman being deceived was in transgression. But this is why Jesus was telling you that the last shall be first and the first shall be last. And then when I tell people that, and you know what, it was another man. Adam slept with a man and he liked it. It say he held it in his bosom. He held it in his heart. He liked it. So it say the last shall be first and the first last. For many be called, but few be chosen. So then when we go back, what this is actually saying is, for Eve was first, then Adam. And Eve was not deceived, but Adam being deceived was in transgression. But Adam framed Eve, and she, you know how we women is, ride or die, gonna ride for them till the wheels fall off. Plus, she, you know, had her partner, but she didn't know because, you know, Adam didn't tell her. Because if you remember from the very beginning, he was the one who was told not to eat from the tree. She was never told because she was not created yet. It's funny how they coming out with this video when I've been telling y'all this and trying to prove this to y'all from the scripture. And they come out with this video depicting the very thing I'm saying. It's called Call Me By Your Name. Scriptures say we are thine. Thou never bearest rule over them. They were not called by thy name. Okay. So I think that's pretty much it. I mean, I don't think I got to do a whole lot to prove what I'm saying. Do your own research. Stay to show yourself approved. Amen. Amen. Okay. I think that's it. I really think that's all I had to say. So the serpent represents the good and evil. So it's the tree knowledge of good and evil. I just showed y'all it I just showed y'all the serpent at the tree in the hieroglyphics. Okay, so shalom family. I love you guys till we meet again.